So it looks like somebody supposedly purchased the Ace family home. And according to the TMG podcast, the owner grossly underpaid. So you guys are probably wondering, what's happening to the Ace family? What's the fate of their home? So let's get into it. So as you guys know, the Ace family is a family vlogging channel who continue to exploit their children online for monetary gain. They also seem to exploit their subscribers with the scams and all of that, but today we're going to be talking about the Ace family home, which has been a hot topic, unfortunately, because they have failed to pay their bills, so they have lost their home. Our friends over at the TMG podcast, the Tiny Meat Cuts, which I don't know what that's supposed to mean, but anyways, they recently posted a podcast where they talked about Austin McBroom. The host of the podcast pretty much shared that he knows the guy who bought Austin's home, which is pretty crazy because we have no record of this. And a lot of you guys are interested in what's going on with this house because it's a really complicated situation. I get emails every single day, and a lot of you guys are like, wait, but Sloan, if you go onto Zillow, you'll see the house has been sold. And the house was sold back in the day, back in 2019, to the Ace family. So if you were to go online and you didn't look at the fine print, you would think that the home was recently sold. But again, it was sold back in May 2019 to the Ace family. So currently, I guess it would be like up for sale from the bank, but we've learned that it's supposedly been bought. But while we're on the topic of public records, and before we get into this podcast, I do want to share there has been an update to the public record system. So this is pretty much a public notice to confirm that yes, the Ace family home was foreclosed. It went up for auction and now it's back at the lender. So when Catherine is out and about saying that her, you know, her home isn't foreclosed, when asked, this document is proof that yes, the home was foreclosed. It's now owned by the bank and Catherine can lie all she wants, but the records don't lie.
Hey Catherine, there's a lot of rumors that your house is getting foreclosed. What do you have to say about that?
It's not true.
Thank you. Okay, you're welcome.
So now let's get into the TMG podcast, which I will link their episode below. But pretty much this guy shares that he knows a real estate agent and he pretty much knows what's been going on with the Ace family home. And actually, he also shares that the person who purchased it got a really great deal. The Ace family were screwed. But if you think about their home in general, it's pretty much on this big hill in the middle of a neighborhood where there are a bunch of nice homes, you know, $1 million, $2 million homes, but nothing like the Ace family. And it's a bizarre situation because they built this custom home in a neighborhood where no one who has the money to purchase this home would like to live, because people who buy $10 million homes want to live in a neighborhood that's a $10 million neighborhood. But go ahead and listen to what he has to say.
I also got insider info from a real estate agent recently that knows about the property.
Oh.
They got completely They got taken for a ride when they bought that house.
Uh-oh.
The next most expensive house is $2 million in that neighborhood.
Oh.
They spent $10 million.
So that guy has a point. Who wants to buy this house in the middle of the neighborhood when it's way overpriced for where it's at? And actually something I found really interesting, we've talked about this home before on my channel, and you guys may or may not know that they did like some, they pretty much built this house through their business. And one thing I found really interesting in this podcast is that he shares that I guess like when Austin was building the home, he like told the permit writers that they were just going there to film. They weren't going to live there. So pretty much they were going to build this big old home and it was going to be for filming purposes only, and it wouldn't actually truly be their home, which I have a feeling he did that to try to avoid maybe some permit things or taxes. Who really knows, regulations? But go ahead and listen to them.
I don't know. They told people that whoever was like writing the
underwriter
permitted to build, they told them that they weren't actually going to live there. They're just going to film there. And they
moved the city that.
Yeah. And they moved in anyways, permanently, right? So anyways.
I don't know why, but when I hear that, I feel like that could be illegal. Like, if you're telling the permit people, like, yeah, this is going to be a commercial space, we're going to film here, we're going to work here, but then you end up living there, I feel like that was a way to try to avoid some regulations or something like that. And then he goes on to share that whoever did buy it at a much lower price because the bank was just trying to get rid of it because they've been wanting their money for so long from the Ace family and they've gotten none of it.
Takes possession of the house and tries to sell it in an auction. Nobody buys it. So somebody else just bought it for super cheap, from the company because they just want some of their money back.
Yeah.
Right.
Once those records do become available, we're going to be able to see how much this person spent on this home. And you guys already know we're going to be here on this channel breaking it all down. But let's go ahead and react together to this last bit. So in this segment of the podcast, he's going to share that he actually knows or at least met the guy who bought the Ace family home. So I don't know. We can't really confirm this again because the public records have not updated for a while. Does not mean that he's lying here because it takes time to update public records, but let's go ahead and listen to what he has to say because this is so interesting to me.
Dude, I know the guy who bought it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was just weird coincidence. I was with him last night and he was like,
does he get both?
He was like, yeah, we just bought this like really, I don't know, like problematic like YouTuber. And I was like, which house? And he said, we bought a problematic house. And I was like, what house? And he's like, I don't know, some YouTuber, he did some boxing thing. And I was like, Austin McBroom. And he was like, yeah, crazy. They got taken for a ride when they built it. Spent way too much money on it. And now it's in this area that the next most expensive house is $2.5 million. So no one wants to buy this $10 million house.
Right.
So it's not worth anything close to that. So they picked it up like for cheap from the loan company. And I guess they're going to try and flip it or something. I don't know.
Do they get both or just the one? Because it's two houses on the property.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I don't know.
If you guys don't know, the Ace family home actually is on three properties, I believe, but there were two houses built and they pretty much stopped the third house from being built and they connected the two houses together and then you've got your big old Ace family mansion. So that's the situation there and that's why the guy was like, oh, two houses, but he's right, but he's also wrong because it's just one house now because they have been connected. So that's pretty much all we know about the Ace family home. But I do want to talk to you guys a little bit about the social gloves boxing situation because there have been updates when it comes to Taylor Holder's lawsuit against Austin McBroom because Taylor wants his money that he was promised. So there haven't been a ton of updates in the social gloves lawsuit, but pretty much we know now that Taylor Holder is settling. So they're going to be settling in court. I don't know if we're going to be able to see that settlement because sometimes they're public, sometimes they're not, but it looks like Taylor and Austin are coming to an agreement, which is interesting because you would think that like Taylor would keep fighting until he gets his money, but maybe Austin is going to pay up during this settlement hearing. So they've got a pending settlement, which is probably good news for Austin because at least one of those lawsuits are coming to an end. But I need to talk about Taylor Holder's lawyer because he is no good. And he's gotten himself in trouble. This guy's name is Bobby, and I guess he did something in court, which is now going to result in him getting some sanctions on him. Here's another YouTube channel I'd like to shout out. It's the Mad Catster, and pretty much this guy, I think, has background in the legal system, and he is really great at explaining what's going on with the McBroom family, so go and check out his channel below. So I'm going to play a clip of this guy explaining what happened with Taylor's lawyer because it sounds like he's up to no good. And I'm sure Taylor isn't getting as much as he could have because he hired a bad lawyer.
Judge put in here that there is going to be monetary sanctions against Taylor Holder's attorney, Bobby Cimini, for failure to appear. That's a big deal. Attorneys are rarely ever sanctioned unless they really, really do something bad. And certainly to get monetary sanctions, the judge has to be really pissed off. So Taylor Holder's attorney really pissed the judge off, and the judge is now going to assess monetary sanctions against his attorney. But the good news for Austin McBroom and I guess for Taylor Holder is there's going to be a settlement. Who knows what it's going to be? Maybe it's going to be in exchange for a whole bunch of Ace family merchandise. I don't know, because I don't know how much cash Austin possibly could have.
I have no idea what this attorney could have done to piss off this judge to where he's getting in trouble now by the judicial system. But if you guys are interested in that, when we find out, I'll let you know. But before we end this video, I do want to show you guys something kind of funny on a light note. Maybe it's not that late. I'm like over here on a light note and you see like these surgery pictures, but I just want to share something I found really funny. Me and my friend were joking about it because as you guys know, the Ace family posted about Catherine's surgery, mommy makeover, and then H3H3 is a podcast and they redid the thumbnail. And when I saw it, I was just like, I could not. Actually, now that I'm looking at it, it looks like he like actually just placed himself over her picture, right? Is that the same? Like, oh my God, it's totally the same. like thing. Whoever like Photoshopped that did really well, but I thought that was really funny and I just wanted to share because I think it's so ridiculous. And it's not like Ethan is just picking on Catherine, because it looks like he does this to a bunch of other people, trolling them with like remaking their thumbnails. But I thought that was just super creative. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Here is my email if you have any other video ideas, and definitely go and check out those YouTubers we mentioned today, especially the Mad Catster. Definitely go and check him out. I'm really excited about his channel and I think he deserves some love. So I'm going to open this P.O. Box package item. Oh my gosh, it's got like big stickers all over it. Well, I guess that's fine because you can see my address on there. Anyways, so I got a new P.O. Box address and I'm actually really excited about it because I like left the postal service to go to UPS and they seem a lot more organized at UPS. So thank you. And actually my mom went through and changed all of my addresses in my video. So thank you, mom. Love you. And let's go ahead and open this package. It looks like it's from Curated by Shades. So I'm guessing maybe some like glasses. I don't know. Shades could be like an umbrella situation. Who knows? Also, I do want to say my birthday is on December 11th. I'm not trying to give promo, but it's coming up. And I just want to say that. Whoa. What is going on here? Okay, so we got some glasses. We have a lot of glasses, actually.
Whoa.
Oh my gosh, so they hooked me up. And here's a little card right here, which everything will be listed below. And they write, "Hi Sloan, big fan of your videos here at The Shades in Southern California." Oh, I'm going to be going halfway here very soon. "Keep it up and keep being you. Enjoy some shades on us. Vincent Smith, owner of The Shades." Thank you so much, Vincent. That's so sweet. So let's go ahead and see what they sent me. These are so nice and there are so many of them, guys. Whoa, hold on. You guys may or may not know, I do wear glasses in my normal life, but I also wear contacts. So these are great whenever I'm wearing my contacts. Whoa, it changed the whole, like these are nice, like I guess blue light ones because everything just got super yellow. Wow. We've got like a funky red one here, which these are so cool. They don't feel like, you know, like these don't feel like costume glasses. Like these feel really nice. Thank you so much, Vincent. Oh my gosh. Look at these. How, I love them. I feel like I'm like going to Miami. I am going to Miami. So these are very Miami, huh? Wow. These are, or I feel like the Khloe Kardashian. That's exactly how I feel. These ones are sick. I really like these. Ooh, yeah. Look at that. I'm gonna have to wear these in California. Very nice. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much. You need to go and check them out below. Everything's listed below. And they literally sent me 10 pairs of glasses. There are so many glasses right here. These ones seem very similar to the ones I just tried on. Like besides having the reflective, they're kind of the same shape. I believe that's like Wayfair or whatever, but these are so cool. And I love the packaging. You are killing it. I need to check out these ones because why are these ones in like a special container? Let's see what's going on here. Oh my gosh. Wow. No, these are Miami. These are Miami. These are so fun. Wow, thank you for sharing these. I like have no sunglasses, man. So these are great. Okay, let's try on these last pair before we close out this video because these are, oh, they're heavy duty. I love them, like big and blue and gold. I've always loved like blue, like kind of reflection with gold frames. I had like glasses like that as a kid. I've always liked those. Wait, can you see my stuff here now? I'm exposing myself with the reflection. These are so great. I'm so impressed with your brand. And thank you so much for sharing these. Like, you answered my prayer because I really need glasses and I didn't even know it. So thank you so much. Go and check out their shop below and I'll see you guys in a new video soon. Bye, guys.